Antarctica is sometimes called the frozen continent, but this is what it would look like underneath all the ice. This is the result of a new study updating a huge collection of measurements to fill in the entire map in higher resolution. Basically, satellite data of the ice surface elevation using radar, LIDAR, and other techniques are combined with radar measurements of the thickness of the ice made from airplanes and helicopters closer to the surface. That lets you calculate where the land surface is down there. So this here is the Transantarctic Mountain Range. It separates what we call the West Antarctic Ice Sheet from the East Antarctic Ice Sheet. All the light blue area is below sea level. A good portion of the Antarctic continent is currently below sea level, even though the thick glacial ice there is resting on solid ground. It's not floating. That's partly because the weight of all that ice makes the continent sag and sink down into the mantle. This is something we call isostasy. This new map is super important because computer simulations of Antarctic ice and sea level rise in a warming world need this to get the behavior of the ice flowing over the ground right. Areas of the ice sheet that retreat downhill as they shrink into areas that are below sea level are particularly vulnerable to shrinking rapidly. That's why glaciologists know the West Antarctic ice sheet is the most sensitive to climate change. So this obviously required a huge international effort with funding from the US National Science Foundation and many other countries. This new paper alone has 82 scientists listed as authors. But all that effort shows us things like this, which would otherwise just be a complete mystery.